great.
That's
Alan.
Marvellous. I'd like to say that there are many awards you can get in this business, but for me, I know this one comes from the people that matter. That's you out there, and I'd just like to thank you very, very much. I'll treasure it.
Thank you, Adam. Well done, Valerie. Thank you very much indeed. Well, a very, very. Well, you haven't got ferrets down your trousers. Hello, how are you?
Fine, thank you very much.
And your head's better since you damaged it doing one
well,
of our
I've still
recording
got
sessions.
The bandage on, but I'm feeling a bit better.
Clare, very nice to see you again. We're talking about sport. We'd like to know the nominations, please.
Okay, well, the nominations are Sebastian Coe, Steve Davis and Kevin Keegan.
And once again, before we find out the news, here we see those three gentlemen, starting off with Sebastian Coe.
And there goes Coe. He's looking for Ovett, wondering where he is. He's right there behind him. And could this be Ovett's first defeat? Ovett is in trouble. And Coe gets the revenge he wants. Coe wins!
Three very talented sportsmen who have all been on Swap Shop over the past couple of years, and it's going to be very, very difficult to decide who's the winner, but the votes will say it. Clare, who is our sportsman for 82?
And the top sports star is Kevin Keegan.
Well, unfortunately, Kevin can't be here today because he's in Germany working very, very hard. But he sent along a substitute, or in fact a number of substitutes, starting with Trevor Brooking. Glenn Hoddle. Kenny Sampson. Bill Neal. Steve Foster. Bill Anderson and Ray Clements. Who's likely to see Kevin first in the foreseeable future?
Senior professional.
Can we pass that on to you, Trevor?
Thank you very much.
Can we pass on to Kevin?
Yes, I'm sure on Kevin's behalf he would want me to thank all the Swap Shop viewers who were kind enough to vote for him, and I hope they all watch us in Spain in the summer.
Yes, well, we obviously all wish you all the very, very best, and the rest of the guys who aren't here today, the very best of luck in Spain. You have a tune out at the moment, don't you? It is definitely going to get worse, because what we want you to do is to present your latest hit record, and will the audience all sing along, please? Half and half. We
got the songs each. Pick a card. Any card you like. Take one. Go on. Go on. Share it to the audience.
Yes, all right.
You all had a good look at it?
Yeah.
That's the chorus.
Yeah, well done. Pick the right card. Now, this is obviously going to be hugely embarrassing for our Scottish friend here. But we hope you're going to lend your professional singing talents and you'll wave your patriotic...
That's what you need all the luck we can get.
Very good. Well, you're a lady. Right. Now, of course, what we really need to complete it as a musical event is a musician and someone who understands the artistry of being able to conduct a live audience. The audience are bumbling and buzzing with anticipation. They are wondering who we have. Ladies and gentlemen, a warm welcome, please, for our conductor today, Mr. Andre Craven.
Thank you, promenaders. Thank you.
Right. Yeah, okay.
Okay.
That's four, right? One, two, three, four. Gentlemen, Keith and Maggie will now leave you to your seats where you can have a quiet drink and repair your voices. Good luck in Spain. Thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, some of the England World Cup squad. Once again, congratulations to Kevin Keegan, our top sportsman for 1982. Clare, thank you very much indeed for coming along. And Swap Shop has always been an international programme in the sense that we have been to Wales, we've been to Northern Ireland and Scotland, so obviously we wish the teams of Northern Ireland and Scotland the very best of luck in Spain as well. Clare, thank you very much for coming
along.
Ladies and gentlemen, Clare Grogan.
Bye-bye.
Hello, darling. Hello, how beautiful to see you, and thank you for having me on this historic show.
And thank you too, if I may, to the people who run that wonderful old folks home nearby the studios, who provided us with our studio audience today.
I thought for one horrible moment you were going to come down the wrong entrance there.
I nearly slid down that spooky old stair. What can I do to make this program even richer and more gorgeous than it is already?
Not a lot, by the way.
I'm not. Am I standing out against the set? In my opera house. Kiddies, this is based on the Sydney Opera House, this frock. It's a lovely place in far away, marsupial-infested Australia.
So, Edna, you must, in your travels, go to a lot of awards presentations.
Not many, no. I mainly receive them. Very rarely do I give them out.
what do you think of awards? Some people think that it's a little bit cheap and nasty. Other people
No, I love it, because I think we work very hard, we people who devote our lives to giving joy and happiness to others, and it's very nice to get little presents, of not necessarily of financial nature, but something which expresses the appreciation of the public, and I think it's very, very important. And I might burst into tears in a minute if I go on like this.
Well, we've asked you to come along just before the burst into tears to tell us about the top man on television. Is there a man that figures in your life?
My husband, but he's not on television. He's on closed circuit television because he's in a hospital and they have to watch him day and night in case he escapes.
Well, here we have our nominations. If you'd like to read them out, please, David.
I'm sorry, darling.
If you'd like just to read those out.
What
for
are
us.
These?
They're the nominations. They
nominations.
Are the three most popular people.
Are they?
You'll announce the winner.
The top man nominations, these are.
Yeah.
The first is for Jimmy Savile. Jimmy Savile, he's the top. I'm sure he's very gifted. Number two, Peter Davison. And number three, Kenny Everett. And the winner...
Just one second. Oh, I'm sorry to touch you. Just one second before you do that. We have an opportunity to see excerpts from those gentlemen's programmes.
Oh, have we?
Starting off...
What a technological miracle that is.
Through the benefit of our television centre satellite, we can give you a clip to start with from Doctor Who.
What a madness, what a madness.
Oi, where do you swim at home?
Clivebridge High School swimming bath.
Is this just the same?
Not quite.
Listen, whew, you keep tickling over.
Yeah.
Will you do me a favour? Will you go and get me the newspaper so I can have a read of the newspaper? Dive out. Ladies and gentlemen, there is nothing like the lap of luxury, as it happens. Goodness gracious.
I'm glad you enjoyed it.
Yes, and I think those who are the losers lose by a very few points in my book. And I look into this golden envelope now because this contains the winner of the top man nominations for this show. Isn't it exciting? Who can it possibly be? I'm trembling with excitement now. It's a yellow card and it's the top man. Ladies and gentlemen and boys and girls, mums and dads, aunties and uncles, grandpas and grandmas, doctors and nurses, it's multi-talented Peter Davison!
Well, the meeting of two cultural giants.
I can't possibly follow that, can I?
Well, you can have our job.
Well, you have, Peter, and congratulations, darling. Before you say your little piece, I'm going to say a poem that I've written. I've just written. I hope I can remember it. I love a awards and those who win them. And I love shows with creatures in them. This little possum has been in too. All creatures great and small, and spooky old Doctor Who. And so I present this Eric Award. May you be like me, universally adored.
Can I say something now? Thank you. I just really wanted to say that it took me 3 hours this afternoon to find my bow tie. I had to borrow my shirt from the BBC, and I have to hold my breath if I'm to get into this jacket, but it's all been worth it, and I'd just like to say thank you very much to all those people who voted for me, and even those who didn't. Thank you.
Peter Davison, thank you.
Oh, gracious.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Wait. I'm here for a little cameo, and I can't go without thinking about Noel. Hear my voice? It's husky, you know, with emotion, because this is a historic moment for this boy. He's moving on to other things, and if it's possible, even greater things. And he's got a lump in his throat too. You know, we've got a funny old animal in Australia that's got a lump in his throat called a goanna. And we have an award in Australia called the Golden Goanna for excellence in all fields. Could you bring it on for me, please? I'm going to present you. I'm going to present you with Australia's top award, the Golden Goanna. Come in, creep in on this. Close up. Close up cameras, creep in. We've got a close up on this Golden Goanna.
Well, I'm,
congratulations,
I'm
Noel.
Speechless. Dave Edna, thank you very much.
You can keep that.
I'll have spare batteries with it.
Hi, darling.
Dame Edna, thank you very much.
Goodbye.
Peter Davison, thank you very much indeed.
Goodbye.
Keith, could you hold on to that for me?